Is that why you're here? Because you believe you can?
Yes.
Good stuff.
Oops. Hey, Robbie.
All right, welcome.
Thank you.
My name is Edie Ann. I'm a superstar director.
Woohoo!
I've been with Sensi for 7 years. Can you all hear me?
Yes.
You good? Okay. I almost went Michaelis, but saved my voice. Been with Sensi for 7 years. The irony is that I started this journey as a hobby. And I remember telling my sponsor, do not bug me. I don't want to be called every 2 weeks to see if I have an order in. Guess where I used to work for. I had direct sales background. I knew I could do it. I just wasn't sure what my expectations for this was going to be yet. And I remember telling her, do not bug me. If I want to do this, I will. If I don't, I'm not going to. I'll do what I want when I want. Pretty stubborn like that. Ask my daughter. So my journey kind of started, and if you asked me to share my story even 3 years ago, it might have sounded different than it's going to sound today. And I think a lot of that is because once you get to a certain point in your journey, you realize some of the things that help you get there. And one of the things was when my son was 6 months old, we had a fire. We lost everything. It was the day before Easter. And I remember our community coming to us with a lot of aid. Like, I never asked for it. We got clothes, we got Easter baskets for my six-month-old. It just was overwhelming to feel the community help that we got. And I remember thinking to myself, God, there is just no way I'm gonna be able to ever repay these people. I don't know how I'm gonna do that. And when I started Sensi, it wasn't apparent yet that that was going to be my tool to help give back. When, I don't know, maybe 4 years ago, we had, the town that I grew up in had a fire on Main Street, and people lost their homes, people lost their businesses, and it hit me. This is it. I can help give back. I can do a fundraiser with Sensi. And I can help give back. And I share this story because I think it's so important when we are recruiting, which is what we're going to talk about today, to share on an emotional level. When we recruit just to recruit to get people on our team, do you know what happens to those people usually?
They fall off.
They kind of fall off, right? Because there's no emotional attachment for them. There's nothing for them to understand why Sensi is it for them. There's no reason, you know, we hear about what's your why. That's a whole new other topic that we could go on, but your why is an emotion. Your why is not the goals that we get to that why. And that's the confusion that a lot of us have. You say, well, what's your why? Well, I love candles. Why do you love candles? Makes my house smell good. I mean, and you can go deeper and deeper into this, but if you don't connect that emotion, you don't even have the drive to continue with your business. Is that true?
Mm-hmm.
If you have no reason to get up in the morning, put your socks on, unless you get flip-flops, and that would be fantastic, because it's too cold, you have no reason if you can't connect emotionally, okay? And everybody's emotional connection is going to be different and deeper than somebody else's. For instance, Courtney Edwards is my sponsor. I don't even know, is she here?
No.
Thanks for the support, Courtney. she'll probably be the next one. But I remember having conversations with her about Sensi, and we had a common ground because our kids went to school together, and we had met through a fundraiser that wasn't so nice because we had a friend that had gone missing, and we were doing a fundraiser for their family, and that's kind of how I was introduced to Sensi. And if she had come to me and said, "Oh, Edie, we can go on trips together, we can make all kinds of money, we can meet people," I would have looked at her and said, "I kind of did that with my corporate job. That's whatever, that's fine, yay." Right? But if she had come to me and knew, which she did, that I had just recently, 1 year previous, stopped working in the corporate world, knew that there was only so much house cleaning I could do, and that I needed something to fill my time, if she hadn't had that conversation with me and connected with me on what I needed, and she heard, "Oh, you know what, Edie? You can do this. This will fill your time. I'll help you." Huh. Okay, let's talk. Right? But if we don't find out what that is, we're not going to be able to recruit properly. They become a number. And that's when they don't stay. Okay? So we don't use... And honestly, recruit and retain the name of... Recruiting, people think of military, right? You're just a number. Come on, recruit, 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 recruit. And sometimes we get into that flow of, that's how we're going to do this. We just need to get more people on the team. We want more people, but we want them to stay. Right? And we're taking a chance that if we didn't connect with them at the beginning to say, "Hey, you can actually give this to Sensi," now you've made it all about them. And now they're not saying, "Oh, well, what's Sensi going to do for me? What's Sensi going to do for me?" That's a recruit mindset. Mm-hmm. That's a numbers mindset, right? Because you're going to figure those things out. But as the recruiter, as the person having conversations with other people, we have got to figure out what they can do for Sensi. Do you know why that's different? How does that feel? Right? So Tina, if I came to you and I said, "Well, Sensi can do this, 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 and this." Mm-hmm. That's great, yay. But you know what, Tina? You are strong. You are able, you can talk to people, you're amazing, and I know that you would do so well at Sensi. Mm-hmm. Whew. Feel different?
Mm-hmm. Much.
You want to join?
Oh, yeah. I'd pick you.
She already did. Right? So there's a big difference between, and that's our job. That's our job, is to have conversations with people and figure out how they fit in this world. I want you to think of five people in your world, okay? You can write them down on your books, in your notebooks. I want you to write down five important or influential people in your world, just your world. Write five people. Think of those five people, and now I want you to determine why would they be amazing Sensi consultants. Think of some words that would describe them, that would make them amazing Sensi consultants. What are some? Just shout them out.
Happy.
What was that?
Happy.
Happy.
Persistent.
Persistent, outgoing,
funny,
eager, yep,
comfortable,
cultivable, yep,
passionate,
determined, those are great, right? So those are the kinds of things that we want to find out about that person to determine how well they would fit into their mold of Sensi, not our mold, right? If there's anything that you guys take away from this session today, is that I want you to remember and understand that recruiting has nothing to do with you. Mm-hmm. Nothing. It has nothing to do with you and what you can get from it. Because as soon as you make it about you, right? Think back to when you first signed up. I don't know what the situation was. I don't know what the story was. But if they had not ever said anything about you and said things like, you know, if you join, I can earn the cruise. Do you know if you join, that's going to make 600 people on my team? Right?
Yep.
That happens, though. It happens, right? And when we do that, we take them completely out of the equation, and they're like, well, why should I even stay? Yeah, I'll join for you so you can win the damn cruise. I'm not going on it. Right? So we can't make it about us. We have got to make it about them. How do we do that? How do we make it about them?
Talk to them.
Mm-hmm. You know, you hear often, we need to build relationships. We need to build relationships. Why? Building relationships doesn't mean I'm going to marry you. It just means I'm going to get to know you. Right? Mm-hmm. Don't be scared of building a relationship. And you know that a relationship can just mean, hey, you know what? I really love your headband. Now, what did that do? I just complimented her, but she stopped what she was doing to give me some attention. Besides the fact that I have a microphone. But do you see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
If you start a conversation by complimenting somebody, you open the door wide open. They're ready to listen because you made it about them. The lead-in? I just did it.
No, I understand that.
I walked right up to you.
How do you bring sensing about to talking to a person that you
good
never
question.
Met?
Okay, so she's asking, I went up to her, I complimented her on the headband, all great and dandy, now I've got an opening. What do I do now? How do I bring sensing into this, right? Well, first and foremost, you need to understand that Sensi may not come up in the first conversation. And it's okay. It's okay. Do you all get that? That it's okay not to have a Sensi conversation on the first conversation?
Mm-hmm.
If it's time-consuming, and not time-consuming, but there's a time constraint, that you might not have this person's attention for 3 days, right? Once you've started the conversation, other things are going to come up. You're going to hear, well, thank you. Well, that was nice of you. Well, I just, you know, today's purple day, so I'm going around and I'm talking to people who have purple shirts on. Well, why are you doing that? Well, it's a Sensi color, and I just love Sensi. And here, you want a sample?
Sure.
If they don't even know what Sensi is, you can't necessarily come on and say, hey, do you want to join my team? Because what just happened in that conversation, and that happens a lot, right? We just turned it around, full circle, and made it about me. Do you want to join my team? You know, you could be at the grocery store standing in line and see somebody that has all kinds of paper plates and napkins and cups and whatever, and you think, oh, are you having a party? Because I party all the time. Right? So, I mean, you have to get comfortable with your business and understanding that it's part of who you are. Because it's so easy for us to walk up to somebody or a friend or an acquaintance and share a piece of gum, even if you don't know them. They could be standing there and offer it to somebody because they're standing there. Why is it so easy for us to do that, but we can't share our opportunity when it's who we are? You've got to be okay. You've got to believe that you can. Right? So if you are creating an emotional attachment for them, and you're doing that by having conversations with them, I have coined this. Nobody's allowed to use it. That's okay. I'm just kidding. I call it emotional marketing versus regular marketing. Okay? That was big words. marketing, think about a commercial on TV, any kind of commercial. And I don't know, maybe you see one for Visa, MasterCard. Okay, so they're showing you a trip that you could use your Visa card on. You know, they're doing all these things. They're trying to make an emotional connection with you, right? What commercials come to mind when you think emotional connection? You might not even know what the commercial's for until the end and realize that that cute little dog that got lost and, right? And all of a sudden this big old Clydesdale comes in. I'm gonna save the day. We all know that's Budweiser, but the horse ain't drinking no beer. Right? Did they connect with you emotionally? Mm-hmm. Wait till next, what is it, next weekend? Yeah? Cool. I love the commercials. Ask my daughter, I hate football. But I love the commercials. I know, everybody's like, okay, but I love the Patriots. I'm not, you know, anti. So when you make that emotional connection with somebody, they're going to remember you, right? Like I said, the horse ain't drinking beer. But you all knew it was Budweiser. Mm-hmm. How about the diaper baby commercials? Yeah. Good Lord. Right? Right? So they're going to remember you, but they're also going to make the association as to, huh, how do I connect with that? Okay? Now, obviously, in a Budweiser or a diaper, not everybody needs those things in their lives. We do know sensing people need it in their life, right?
Yeah.
We just need to figure out how. Right? So building that emotional connection to find out why Sensi would be good for them versus how they would be good for Sensi. And that's the shift that I want you guys to make. Okay? It's important for us to share our story of how we joined Sensi, how we came to know about it, what we're hoping it will do for us, because we're hoping, right, we share our story because we're hoping it will resonate with somebody. It's like throwing popcorn out and hoping somebody catches a piece. It's good, and it has its place and time. But we need to be able to switch that over and say, how can you help Sensi? Because you're an amazing person, and you have what it takes to be a director, and you have the awesomeness that grows a team, and you're outgoing, right? Mm-hmm. Don't cry. Love you. Emotion, right? That's big stuff. Because what happens now is we get into the retaining aspect of it, and people are going to stay. I know Robbie's not going anywhere. I just made him cry. Right? When you can connect that severely with something because it's yours, and not because I needed another director on my team, or not because I needed to earn a trip, or not because you want them to earn a trip. Maybe they've been on a gazillion trips, and they don't want to go to Greece or Africa. Right? You gotta make that connection because the retaining aspect of it isn't gonna happen. And you know what's awesome? Is it's not too late if you've already recruited people. to get to that connection, to help retain them and keep them in the Sensi spirit and the Sensi love, right? So some of the things that we do as leaders to help people stay is building a team page, right? We have a team, hi. Oh, you look like somebody else. I love that when that happens. Don't you love that when that happens? Hi, anyway. My face red. When you have the ability to bring them into an environment that is full of love and caring and understanding and empowerment, you're going to get a lot of retention. We're going to have a lot of people stay. Group pages do that, right? I encourage my team, if you've got one person that you've recruited, make a team page. Start building your culture now. Start building it now. And when I say team page, I actually mean group. Like maybe on Facebook or whatever you decide to do. Hey, Dan, how are you? I knew that one. When you create a group, you're now creating a culture, a safe environment, and a way to get to know your people better. Right? So that's why I'm saying it's not too late. If you've already recruited people and you think, oh man, you know, I sold them on the whole cruise thing and making more money and meeting more people and doing all these fun things. What if that really wasn't their thing? It's okay. We can still find out. It's actually easier because we know them now. And we don't have to do the whole headband compliment, right? We can actually go up to somebody in our team and say, Tina, why are you here? You know, why are you feeling Sensi is for you? How can I help you figure that out? Because if I know what she wants, I can help her, right? If I don't know what she wants, I can't help her. So you have to have those conversations, and inside of a group page like that can be advantageous, right? Be able to do that? So how many of you, with a show of hands, have a team group page for your own group? Awesome. Awesome. And how many of you are directors that rose your hand? Love that. Not that I don't want you guys to be directors. I'm glad that you're starting it now. It's important to build that culture, right? In order to keep people, we got to figure out what their why is. We've got to emotionally connect and figure out what is driving them every morning, what is getting them up, and having them want the desire to have Sensi in their life. Usually the people that don't want to recruit don't know what their why are. Why is. Would that make sense to you? Mm-hmm. If they don't want to recruit, I'll be careful there, because honestly, they could have a why that does not include recruiting. Not sure how, because there would have to be a really strong why for not the money not being the reason, right? Because ultimately what happens, and I know we don't want to admit this, but ultimately the money aspect of our business is going to drive us closer to our why. Is that true? Can we admit that and be okay with that? People are so adamant. Oh, I didn't join for the money. Okay. You join to meet people, you join to go on trips. Well, guess what comes with that?
Money.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
I used to say that. I didn't join for the money. I didn't even join to be a superstar director. I joined as a hobby. And look where I am now. Still a hobby. Something I love to do, right? So when you are thinking about the aspect of keeping teammates after you've recruited them, how many of you feel that that is, okay, let me put it back. Recruiting. How many feel that that's hard to do? What story are you telling yourself? Right? We just learned that. So what story are you telling yourself about yourself and recruiting? It's hard. I can't do it. I don't know how to talk to people. Right? Mm-hmm. So what if we changed that story and we said something like, recruiting's not hard because other people are doing it. And I'm going to get better at it. Matter of fact, I'm doing better because I'm sitting in this class. Right? Think about the story that you continue to tell yourself. Because you know the irony is? 80% of our thoughts come from our... This is bonus information, by the way. 80% of our thoughts come from our unconscious mind. Did you know that? And it's your best friend because it believes everything you tell it. So if you're saying recruiting is hard, your unconscious mind is going, huh? Yep, it is. But if I told it, you know what, recruiting's really not that hard because other people are doing it, my unconscious mind would say, well, if somebody else is doing it, then why aren't we? Right? So check the story that you're telling. How many of you know you can recruit? I should see everybody's hands. How many of you think you can recruit? Okay, there's more hands. If your hand's not risen, then you need to check your story, okay? Just remember that and know that that's a big part of our internal push, okay? Our job to help people stay is to help them figure that out. Right? Mm-hmm. It's for us to say, you're here. You're with Sensi. What do you want from this? How do you think you can help this company? Because I know how awesome you are. Do you know how awesome you are?
Yes.
Yes.
Right? Is there a time check? Because I just run over time all the time. What is it?
11:18.
10 minutes left? Okay. So our job is to make sure that when we do have somebody on our team, we can connect with them and say, hey, what do you want out of this? Where is your... Hi, Jennifer. I don't call people out, ever. It's to make sure that they have an understanding of where they fit in this company, right? Because the ones that kind of fall off never really knew how Sensi could be a catalyst in their life, right? So we weren't able to connect with them on that emotional level to find out what they wanted out of this so that we could help them achieve those things. If you really thought that you were coming to this class to find out a step-by-step way to recruit somebody and to retain them, that's it. It's the emotion. You've got to connect with them. You've got to build a mini relationship and say, okay, what do I know about you? How do I know what you can give to Sensi? Because if I tell you what I can do, you might check out almost immediately in that conversation. Mm-hmm. That true?
Yep. Absolutely.
So much funner to talk about ourselves, right? And you love it when most people, not everybody, they think they don't like it, but they really do. When people talk about you in a loving and awesome way, right? We do. So that's what we need to do, is we need to connect, we need to find that emotional attachment, We need to have conversations with them. We need to make sure that they know how awesome they are and how amazing they're going to be at Sensi. And then once they're here, we keep reminding them, right? And a good way to do that is in a team page, one-on-one phone calls, right? Mm-hmm. And knowing that no matter where they are in your downline, that they matter, right? That they're worth your time. Sometimes I hear leaders say things like, oh, well, if they're 5 and 6 generations down, you're not getting paid on them. Really? Really? You're not going to retain people that way. Because now what happened? It just all of a sudden came right back and made it about me or you or whatever. Right? What do you think about the story that you're telling about recruiting? Is that something you guys can work on?
Yes.
Believe it or not, you're going to be working on it more this today. Because we're all about belief today, right? We have to believe that we can recruit. If there is no belief that we can recruit, it ain't going to happen at all. Because your unconscious mind is going to say, you just told me I can't recruit, so I'm not going to... You're my best friend. I can't go against you. Right? Mm-hmm. Okay. So, what time? Where are we? 11:22. Oh, so that was only 2 minutes that went by just now. I actually am going to open it up. And I want to know how you feel about the story you're telling, the ability to emotionally connect with the person that you're trying to recruit, and then how you're going to be able to keep them. Is there any questions around that that I can actually address? That's not going to fill 7 minutes. Yes.
I've recruited so many people on my team, and then they have left because they give up too quick. I tell them it's not an overnight success. I try to train them. They say that they want to make it a business, and then they just give up. How do you retain them once you get them?
Thank you for asking that, and thank you for being honest and vulnerable, because I can guarantee you there's a lot of people in this room that feel the same way. Not your answer. The biggest difference is that I have these conversations, and I have team members here. You can ask them. I'm not just fluffing this up just to make it sound good. We have one-on-one conversations. We dig really, really deep to figure out why they're even here. And I'm brave enough or courageous enough to say, Tina, why are you in Sensi in the first place? Like, why? Because I'm not the one that needs to convince her. She needs to convince herself that this is an amazing opportunity. And if I don't put her in that spot or in that place mind-wise, she's going to leave. There's no connection. There's no emotional connection there. Right? So all of these people that say they want to make the business, well, why do they want the business? What's it going to do for them? And once they figure that out, ask them why that's important. And when they say, it's important because of this, why is that important? And at some point in that why figuring out, they're going to come down to a point where either tears are going to start flowing, or they're going to be like, oh, you want to know what my why is? I never felt like I was enough in my life. I need to feel like I'm enough. Like what I say is enough, what I do is enough, what I hear, whatever. I never felt that. Can I just tell you? Sensi makes me feel like I'm enough. And that's why I get up every morning. And when you can connect with that, They'll stay. They'll stay. You need to dig deeper then. So the ones that are leaving haven't figured that out yet. They call it attrition for a reason. Becca Levi once told me, you have to have 33% of your business needs to be yours, 33% of your business needs to be people coming in, and 33% of your business needs to be people getting out so that you can recirculate those people in. I have an analogy, I'm not going to go into it now, but it's building a house. And your foundation is very important, and those are the people that do the minimum every 3 months. But then there's some that are gonna fall through the cracks, and you better be prepared to fill those cracks with more cement, more foundation, right? So there's gonna be people that go. And most of the time, I can almost guarantee it, it's because they have not connected with why they're doing this in the first place. And they may never. So you're right in that aspect. The only part of your job that could potentially help them is helping them dig. I don't do much when I stand here and talk to Tina and say, well, why is that important? And then she, why is that important? Why is that important?
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
There's not a lot that we're doing, but we're instigating, we're inspiring, we're allowing them to understand that that's important. Does that help? Anybody else? Thank you guys very much.